Hello students, welcome to Saurav sir's classes. In this video we are going to solve Amazon placement paper. So basically we are going to solve the Amazon company's placement paper in which they test about the aptitude of the candidates. So beginning with the first question, here you can see the question number 1 says, if A and B are positive integers and A minus B divided by 3.5 is equal to 4/7, then you can see here we have 4 inequalities in A and B. So first, simplifying this equation, here we can write A minus B divided by 3.5 is equal to 4/7. So we will multiply 3.5 both sides. So here we will have 4/7 into 7/2. So this will come up to 2. So this is equal to 2. So A minus B is equal to 2, or we can also say A minus B is greater than 0. Since 2 is greater than 0, then A minus B is also greater than 0. So A is greater than B. So in this case we are getting A is greater than B, which is option number A. Hence option A is the correct answer. And if we have got A minus B less than 0, in that case A should be less than A, could have been the less than B. Or if A minus B is equal to 0, we would have got A equal to B. But these two conditions are not true. Here we have got A minus B greater than 0, so A is greater than B. And in case of the fourth option, here you can see we have two options. Either A can be equal to B or A can be less than B. But in this equation, you can see that there is only equal to and we have no alternate options. So option D is automatically got cancelled. So our answer from this we have got to be A is greater than B, which is option number A. Now moving on to the next question, question number 2 here. Question 2 says, if 5 women or 8 girls can do a work in 84 days, in how many days can 10 women and 5 girls can do the same work? So here we are talking about a work that is done in 84 days by 5 women or 8 girls. So they are not working together, but the work can be done by 5 women in 84 days, or the work can also be done by 8 girls in 84 days only. Now we need to find in how many days will 10 women and 5 girls collectively do the work. So what we can do here is, as you can see, 5 women are equivalent to 8 girls. Because as you can see, 5 women can also do the work in 84 days, as well as 8 women can also do the work in 84 days. So 5 women are equal to 8 girls. Now from this we can say that 10 women are equivalent to 16 girls. We are just multiplying by 2. So 10 women are equivalent to 16 girls. So as you can see from here, we have 10 women and 5 girls. So we need to find the number of days required for 10 women and 5 girls to do the same work. So 10 women means 16 girls. From here you can see 10 women are equivalent to 16 girls, and we have 5 more girls. So total 21 girls. So basically we need to find the number of days 21 girls take to do the same work that is done by 8 girls in 84 days. So here you can see 8 girls or 5 women, but we will consider girls over here. So 8 girls do the work in 84 days. So if we divide the girls in, like if we consider one girl, so obviously she will take much more days by the 8 girls. So this will be 84 into 8 days. Since 8 girls take 84 days, then one girl will obviously take 84 into 8 days. And now we need to find how many days will 21 girls take. So 21 girls will obviously take lesser amount of days. So 84 into 8 divided by 21, this is cancelled by 4, which is equal to 32 days. So basically 21 girls will take 32 days to complete the work, the same work. Or instead of 21 girls, we can say 10 women and 5 girls, which is required in the question, that 10 women and 5 girls can do the same work in 32 days. So in options, you can see option number D says 32 days. So option D is the correct answer to this question. Now moving on to the next question, which is question number 3. So question 3 says, walking at 3/4 of his usual speed, a man is late by 2.5 hours. The usual time is, okay. So the man is walking slower than his lower usual speed, and obviously he is late by 2.5 hours. So we need to find what is the usual time the man takes. So let us consider the usual speed of the man be S. So usual speed of the man is S. So the new speed is 3/4 of s, because they are walking at 3/4 of s usual speed. So the usual speed is s, so the new speed is 3/4 of the s. Now let us assume the usual time to be t. Let us assume the usual time to be t. So the new time will be 2.5 hours of t, which will be 5/2 t. So this is the new speed, this is the new time. So what we can see over here, since the distance is the same, we have not been said anything about the distance, so we are assuming that the distance the man is walking will be same. In that case, the speed and the time will be inverse to each other. So since the new speed is 3/4 s, so the new time with this respect should be 4/3 s. So this 4/3 s is basically the new time, so not the s but t. So 4/t is basically the new time, and we need to find, and here you can see the man is late by 2.5 hours. So what we need to find is, we need to find the difference between the new time and the old time. So the old time, as we have considered to be usual time, which is t. So the new time, which is 4/3 t, since the man is walking 3/4 of his usual speed, so the time taken by him will be 4/3 of the usual time minus the usual time, that is the difference, and this will give us the total time that the man was late. So man was late by 5/2 t. So this is the time that is, that gives us the total time the man was late. So calculating this, we have 4t minus 3t divided by 3 is equal to 5/2 t. So in this case, we have t by 3 is equal to 5/2 t. Oh, sorry, this will not be 5/2 t, but this will be only 5/2, because as you can see, we are talking about the time that is 2.5 hours. So we are not assuming that the this is not a part of the usual time, but this is actually the time which the man was late. So this will be 5/2 and not 5/2 t. So here you can see we have t by 3 is equal to 5/2. So t is given by 15/2, which is nothing but 7.5 hours. So 7.5 hours, which is 7.5 hours. In option B, you can see we have 7.5 hours. So option B is the correct answer to this question. Now moving on to the next question, which is question number 4 here, which says, in a boat, 25 persons were sitting. So we are talking about a boat which was consisting of 25 people or persons. Their average weight increased 1 kilogram when one man goes and a new man comes in. Okay, so the average weight of this boat, or the all the people in this boat, is increased by 1 kilogram when a man is replaced by a new man. Now the weight of the new man is 70 kgs. Okay, so we have been given the weight of the new man that has replaced our old man. Now we need to find the weight of the man who is going. Okay, so we need to find the man who is leaving the boat or who goes from the boat. So first let us take old and new. We'll make two different columns for old and new. So in this case, old, here we, let us assume that the average weight of the boat was x. So the total weight will be 25x, because there are 25 people or 25 persons in the boat, and we have assumed x to be the total weight. So 25x will be the total weight when there were no shifting. Now the new weight is 25, but x plus 1. Since you can see that the average weight gain is in average. Okay, so here you can see the average weight has increased by 1. So the average weight is x plus 1, and again there are 25 people, because one man goes and another man joins. So there are 25 people, so the total weight will be 25x plus 1. Now as you can see from the old, we can say that we will assume that the man who leaves was of y kgs, and in new, as you can see here, we have the addition of 70 kgs, because the new man who comes up is of 70 kgs, and the old man who left what was y kgs. So we are assuming the old man who is going, the man who left the boat, to be of y kgs, and this is the term we need to find, because you can see we need to find the man, the weight of the man who is going, and we have assumed the weight of the man to be y. So here we can write 25x was the total weight of the boat before the replacement. After since replacement, the y kgs man has left, and there is a new man who came, and the weight of the man is 70 kgs. So the total weight now has become x 25x plus 1. So simply we can find the value of y from here. So this will be 25x minus y plus 70 is equal to 25x plus 25. So 25x and 25x gets cancelled from both the sides. We are left with y is equal to 70 minus 25, which is 45. So why is 45 and why is the weight of the man who is going? So our answer is 45. In options, you can see option number A says 45. So option A is the correct answer to this question. Now moving on to the next question. Question number 5 here. So question number 5 says, in a group of cows and hens, the number of legs are 14 more than the twice the number of the heads. The number of cows is. So here we are talking about a group in which there are cows and hens, and the number of legs, including the cows and hens, are 14 more than the twice the number of heads of the cows and hens, and we need to find the number of cows. So let the number of cows be x and the number of hens be y. So simply, as you know, there are 4 legs of a cow and 2 legs of a hen. So total number of legs will be 4x. So this will be 4x plus 2y. So these are the total number of legs, and now this is equal to 14 more than twice the number of heads. So first of all, number of heads will be x plus y, because every cow and every hen has obviously one head each. So there are total number of x plus y heads, and this is twice plus 14. So here you can see number of legs, this number of legs is 14 more than twice the number of heads. So what we have got over here is 4x plus 2y is equal to 2x plus y plus 14. Now simply we can solve this. 4x plus 2y is equal to 2x plus 2y plus 14. So we will cancel 2y from both the sides, and we are left with 4x minus 2x is equal to 14. Therefore x is equal to 7, and as we have assumed the number of cows be x, and which is equal to 7, and we needed the number of cows, so our answer is 7. That is option number B. So option B is the correct answer to this question. Now moving on to the next question, which is question number 6 over here. So question number 6 says, two trains starting at the same time from two stations 200 km apart and going in opposite directions cross each other at a distance of 110 km from one of the stations. What is the ratio of their speeds? So here we are talking about two trains, and they are moving in the opposite directions, and the total distance between the two stations is 200 kilometers. Now they meet at somewhere this point, which is 110 kilometers from one of the stations. So basically they are not meeting exactly in the center. Therefore the speeds of the trains are different. So they are meeting at some point here, which is 110 kilometers from one of the stations, and obviously, since the distance between both the stations is 200 kilometers, therefore the distance between the other station will be 90 kilometers. So if they meet over here, they will have a 110 kilometer distance from one station, and 90 kilometers distance from the next station. So what we need to find is, we need to find the ratio of their speeds. As you can see, the distance traveled by the train are same. Both the trains should travel 200 kilometers, and since the distance traveling by the train are same, what we know is the ratio of the speed, not the ratio, but the their speeds as well as the time taken will be inverse to each other. So since the distance is same, distance is constant, therefore speed is inverse to time. That is, speed 1 time 1 can be written as speed 2 time 2. So basically they are inverse to each other. And in this case, as you can see, there are 100 km and 90 km is the distance remaining. So the speeds can be written as 110:90, or we can also write this as 90:110. And basically this will be the ratio of their speed. So as you can see, we have two options where the simplified will be 11:9 or 9:11, because we have not been said anything about which train to consider first. So our possible answers are 11:9 or 9:11. And this dilemma can be solved just by looking at the options. In options, you can see we have 11:9. So 11:9 will be the correct answer to this question. Or even if we had option 9:11, 9:11 would have been the correct answer. But in option, you can see we have option number A as 11:9. So 11:9 is the correct answer to this question. So I would like to end this video. Here you will find more solutions to such companies' placement papers in our further videos.